We're going to take a closer look at the Yoast SEO meta box, and remember that it shows up when you're editing a post. The first tab we're going to look at is the readability tab in the content optimization tab. And it's a straightforward analysis of your readability. As you can see here, I only have two categories, improvements and good results. But there's four categories in total. You also have problems when you're doing something really wrong and considerations. We're going to go into these four categories in detail in the next module. And what you see here is a bit of feedback which tells you if you're doing things right or wrong and what you should do to make sure that you're doing things better. What's very convenient is that you have a little eye here, which means that you can highlight the results in the text. So the feedback also shows where you're doing things wrong. The second column shows insights. This is only in premium, by the way, and it shows you what are the most prominent words in your texts so that you can make sure that your keyword strategy matches what words you're using in your texts. The SEO analysis is a bit longer, and it consists of several different boxes. The first one is the snippet preview, and this allows you to watch a preview of what your search result may look like in Google. It's not definitely what you will see because Google can change things. We don't have influence on that, but it's a good idea, and most of the time, this is what it will look like. And you see here that you have the title of the page, the URL or the slug, and the meta description. You can toggle between the desktop view and the mobile view. So you'll see what it looks like on desktop and mobile. And you can also edit the snippet to make suggestions to Google. So you have an SEO title here, and you can actually edit the slug here and modify your meta description by editing it in this box. One of the most important things is filling in your focus keyword, because that allows the feedback to give feedback on your focus keyword. The focus keyword in this article was SEO strategy. And you also can tick a box here to make sure that it's cornerstone content. So we've talked about cornerstone content in the previous video. It's your most important articles. And if you tick this box, the analysis will be a bit stricter. And as you can see here, I have three categories. There are problems in this piece as well, four problems, two improvements, and six good results. And again, you can sometimes click the eye to highlight the results in the text. This one also has the insights column as well. The third one is only available in premium and allows you to add another focus keyword. So the same analysis, the same SEO analysis shows up for that additional keyword. If we go to the social tab, you can see that there are two tabs you can work on. You have a Facebook and a Twitter one, and this simply allows you to upload a Facebook image, to edit the Facebook title, and to edit the Facebook description, similarly to the snippet editor. And the Twitter one works the same way. So that's quite simple. And the advanced tab allows you to edit some things, and you should really only do that if you are an SEO expert, because this can break a lot of things. The first one is simply indicating whether you want the search engines to show this post in the search results, and there are three options. You can either say follow the default settings, which I have already specified in the plugin itself, in the plugin settings, or you can say yes or no and make sure that you don't follow the default. So if you want to do something different than the default, you have to be here. You can also indicate whether search engines should follow links on this post, and we're going to go into why you should do this or not do this in another lesson, but you can do it here. And you can put in some advanced settings for meta robots, and you should really only do this when you know what you're doing anyway. And you can fill in canonical URLs. And if you want to know what that is like, you should go to the Under the Hood of Yoast SEO module right at the very end of this course.